It has been a hot 4th of July around here. There's a look at the temperatures at the mid-afternoon in the 90s, and we've been as high as 92 degrees here in Jackson. Real feel numbers over 100. We do have showers and thunderstorms, though, scattered mainly east of the metro and south. Right now, we have thunderstorms from Forest up towards Philadelphia, stretching back to near Meridian. Temperatures down in the low 80s because they have thunderstorms around Meridian. Laurel and Hattiesburg seeing some thunderstorms, and even in our southern counties from Brookhaven through Monticello and Prentice seeing some scattered showers and thunderstorms. Temperatures there are cooler because of the rain, but in areas where it has not rained, 94 for Macomb right now, 93 currently in Natchez, and you factor in the humidity and these real fill numbers even higher. There's the radar in motion. Again, these storms are not moving that quickly. They're drifting basically off to the south and to the west. And through the evening, there could be a couple more pop-up downpours before everything begins to wind down as we head towards sunset. Right now, though, 91 at Vicksburg, 94 Port Gibson. You factor in the humidity. These are the real fill numbers right now. Feels like 99 here in Jackson. Feels like 109 at Hazelhurst and Port Gibson. Feels like 104 at Natchez and a 104 at Macomb. I don't think it's a 114 at Brookhaven, but you get the picture. It is hot all across the region thanks to high pressure, which has basically moved right overhead. And you see how everything just kind of rotates around this big area of high pressure. And most of the storms today have occurred in East Mississippi, not so much in the west. And I expect that trend to continue again tomorrow. There could be more scattered showers and downpours, but primarily east of Metro Jackson, more towards the Mississippi-Alabama line. So as we head through the evening, anything that develops will begin to diminish. And then it's going to be another steamy night. Low temperatures only down in the mid 70s. And then tomorrow we warm up quickly. And by noon, temperatures will be up near 90. We'll have scattered downpours developing, and they could move through the area again. Quick heavy downpour, thunder and lightning, gusty winds will be the main threat, and then everything should diminish as we head into the sunset hours. Very typical summer-like pattern. Highs for tomorrow, 93 degrees here in Jackson, 94 Yazoo City, 93 degrees at Vicksburg, and we continue with the hot weather through the rest of this week. Each and every day, there is the chance of maybe a couple pop-up downpours, but the main weather story is going to be the heat and the humidity. Real fill numbers by the end of the week will be up near 110 degrees. Here are the real fill numbers tomorrow. 107 here in Jackson may feel like 110 up in the Delta, 109 for Yazoo City. And this is the type of heat where you want to limit and stop your activity during the hottest part of the day, 10 a.m. to about 7 p.m. Want to do any strenuous activity either late in the evening or early in the morning before the heat really kicks in. And here are the real fill numbers for the week. Again, 110 as we head into the weekend. Very dangerous real fill numbers. Checking the tropics, we are all quiet, which is some great news. All right, forecast for tonight. Temperatures down in the 70s, very warm and summery. Tomorrow, 93, a tropical feel, hot and humid with some scattered afternoon thunderstorms, 93. Real fill numbers will be well over 100. Tomorrow night, steam bath city, very muggy. Low temperatures only down in the mid-70s, and there's your 7-day forecast. Those temperatures climb up to 95 and 96 by the end of the week. Can't rule out a late-day storm, but the majority of us staying dry.